Alright, so we are here at Nature's Emporium with one of their in-house nutritionists, Nicole. And I wanted to talk to Nicole a little bit about meal planning, specifically meal prepping beforehand. I'm hearing a lot of our users at Meal Garden are enjoying the weekly plans, and they like the idea of planning out their meals, picking their recipes, pinning them to their calendar, but they also want some guidance in terms of, you know, oh, well, when should I prep this? When should I batch cook everything on Sunday? Sort of some guidelines on, you know, when to be soaking things, when to be, you know, cooking things at certain, you know, up to certain points. And so I kind of wanted to get your take on the whole, you know, meal planning for the week ahead thing. Are there any kind of topics?
For sure. So meal planning really is like your biggest key for success, because if you neglect the time to meal plan, your whole week just ends up being rushed, and you can end up resorting to something that's easier for dinner instead of something that you could have prepared for ahead of time. So I guess some of the easiest things is you kind of need to know what you're going to be making, so you have everything kind of laid out in front of you, and then you can decide, okay, if I have to soak these legumes, like what day can I soak them on? Normally it's about a day before. If I'm doing any roasted veggies, you could batch cook that stuff on the weekend. Making things like quinoa and rice, you could batch cook that again and have it just in the fridge ready to go.
How long would quinoa last?
If you're making it on a Sunday, it should last until the Friday, no problem at all. I just go by how it smells and how it looks, and if I'm weirded out by it, I toss it, but for the most part, it's good till Friday.
Okay. And legumes, you were saying you should soak those,
yes.
Usually it's overnight, right?
Yes, normally overnight. Make sure you're always soaking your legumes in warm water with a little bit of apple cider vinegar or lemon juice, and it will help to increase the digestibility. And soaking also increases the cooking time, or decreases the cooking time, sorry.
Oh, so, yeah. Awesome. And that's actually something good to note. So once you get sort of these key dates established and time frames, you can actually make a note in Meal Garden, put on your calendar, you know, time to soak the nuts or time to soak the legumes the day before. That way you're ready when you go ahead.
Yeah.
And are there certain sort of recipes or types of meals that you'd recommend in order to simplify
One pot meals are the absolute best.
Yes.
So crock pot meals like chilies and stews and soups, I love them because it's a little cleanup and easy to store, and those things are going to last in the fridge for a week, and then they're easy to just reheat to grab and go.
Yeah.
They're like my biggest go-to by far, is like one pot meals, one pan meals.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Nicole.
Yeah,